surgery room, which is equipped with the Da Vinci robotic system. This system is a new era in the development of laparoscopic surgery. Da Vinci enables the surgeon to be precise during the operation, allows to cut and separate the tissue at an angle, work with needles. Thus, the robot allows to perform a wide range of operations in gynecology, oncology, urology, gastroenterology, and the other fields of medicine. Professor Fuat Demirci, tell us please about this robotic surgical system.
Robotic surgery is the highest point in the development of laparoscopic surgery. If the regular closed operation had some shortcomings, with the advent of surgical robots that perform laparoscopic surgery, these shortcomings have been eliminated. The Da Vinci surgical system consists of three blocks. The first one is the surgeon's console, through which the surgeon controls the robot. Second is the monitor, through which a surgical team conducts monitoring of the operation. The third block is the device itself with robotic arms. First of all, the robotic arms installed in surgical site of the patient's body. Then the surgeon takes his place at the first block, and then sitting behind a special screen and using the console's master controls begins to maneuver the robotic arms and this way conducts the operation. Da Vinci is equipped with four robotic arms. One arm provides video surveillance with a telescopic camera that allows to see the surgical field, and the other three are used to perform the surgery. Robotic arms function as the surgeon's hand and refine its movements. Usually we use in laparoscopic surgery tools that are straight and therefore functional not enough. A robotic arm rotates 540 degrees. The most important advantage is in the possibility to perform surgical operations in the abdominal cavity within the narrow surgical field that is limited to the surgeon's hand movements. This surgical system allows to perform the surgical removal of uterine fibroids using the closed method without opening the abdomen and put stitches in a narrow surgical field.
What kinds of operations are performed in gynecology?
The Da Vinci surgical system allows to perform about 90% of gynecological operations. In most of cases, this device is used in gynecological cancer operations relating to uterine cancer, cervical cancer, and rarely ovarian cancer. The second type of operation is a myomectomy. This method is similar to the method of an open surgical removal of the fibroids, but the difference is concluded in a closed type of surgery, which allows to apply all kinds of stitches. In addition to above-mentioned surgery, we perform a hysterectomy, an operation carried out in case of the fallopian tube obstruction. In brief, the Da Vinci surgical system allows to perform most of the operations. Another advantage of the Da Vinci robot is in providing us with a visualization of the surgical field in a high 3D definition, as in conventional surgery, the surgeon monitors the surgical field only in two dimensions. The Da Vinci console's master control enables the surgeon to monitor all the surgical field with enhanced vision in a high-definition resolution HD, as well as increase or decrease the apparent field of view in 20 times. The operations performed by the Da Vinci robotic system have a lot of advantages in comparison with open surgery. For example, if while performing open oncological operations on uterus, we usually make a long incision on the patient's body. But the Da Vinci system allows us to make the same surgical treatment using only five small incisions, and each of them about 1 centimeter. Thus, we reduce blood loss and the risk of infection and post-operative pain. According to the scientific researchers, the Da Vinci robotic system, in comparison with open surgery, allows to make huge amount of operations on the lymph nodes, thereby increasing the effectiveness of treatment.
How many doctors are included into the surgical team during a conventional operation?
The surgical team consists of two surgeons. One of them works as an assistant and the second one operates through the surgeon's console control. And of course, there is also a nurse and an anesthesiologist in the surgery room.
Da Vinci is highly effective in the surgical treatment of complicated forms of cancer and uterine myoma, ovarian tumors, and prostate cancer. We also use this robotic system in general surgery to treat obesity and other diseases of the gastrointestinal tract, such as gastroesophageal reflux, which has a high cancer risk. What kind of operations does this robotic system enable you to perform?
Concerning general surgery, we can easily perform almost all operations related to obesity and gastroesophageal reflux. The surgical indication for obesity surgery is a body mass index exceeds the number of 30. Even if the index exceeds the number 40 and there is no contraindication to the surgery, we can also perform such an operation.
What kind of operation is it? Is it a kind of liposuction or gastrography?
There are many different methods of operations depending on the degree of obesity and coexisting diseases of the patient. A lot of specialists mostly prefer to use a classic method bypass, gastric bypass surgery. But in recent years, we have preferred to perform sleeve gastrectomy surgery, which means reduction of the stomach volume.
How long is a rehabilitation period?
After gastric bypass operation, patients should stay for 7 days in our hospital. In case of sleeve gastrectomy, our patient can be discharged after 5 days. If we perform a closed surgery operation, the post-operative period passes easier and more comfortable for our patient. Rehabilitation period is shorter than in case of open surgery. Our patients can move by themselves without any additional help in a day after the operation have been done. On the second post-operative day, our patients can eat liquid food. On the fifth day, mashed food.
As I know, you make gastroesophageal reflux operations. Could you please tell us about it?
Performing such a kind of operation, we also take into account many factors. Anatomical features of our patients, structural features of the esophagus, and the stage of disease. The Da Vinci system enables us to perform the operation making just incision. In case of esophageal reflux and hiatal hernia, we perform herniography, create special wall by using the patient's own tissue.
How long is the rehabilitation period and when your patient can start eating?
The surgery operation takes 30 to 40 minutes. Our patients stay in hospital for one night. Next morning, we give them a very light breakfast. If patients live in Istanbul, we discharge them on the next day after the operation. If a patient is a foreign citizen, his hospitalization period can take 2 days. And on the third or fourth day, the patient can be provided with a permission to return to his homeland.